DHS insider suggests is about to happen is exactly what many of us fear, a police state takeover of America. Tommy Varreau. The following interview is both informative and terrifying, an essential reading for anyone concerned about what comes next. What the DHS insider suggests is about to happen is exactly what many of us fear, a police state takeover of America, with urban centers to be pacified first, all outspoken critics of the government to be silenced, and travel restrictions across the United States to come shortly thereafter. The dollar collapse, riots, the mobilization of domestic law enforcement, gun control, rationing of food and gas, suspension of the United States Constitution and a complete lockdown of America as we know it. According to the report, sinister forces within the United States government operating at the highest levels of our country's political, financial, intelligence and military hierarchies have set into motion a series of events that will leave the populace so desperate for government intervention that they'll willingly surrender their liberty for the perceived security of a militarized police state. Interviewer Doug Hagman cites an anonymous source operating deep inside the Department of Homeland Security, which may leave many skeptical of the accuracy of the reports. But the fact is, were such events being planned behind the scenes, we certainly wouldn't be given official mainstream warning. If real, the report is a game changer, and it makes sense that anyone privy to such information would want to keep their identity hidden. Whistleblowers in America who expose the corruption of officials in our government are treated not as patriots, but as traitors, and are often branded as psychos or terrorists. What's most alarming is the speed at which these events may play out. The latest from DHS Insider, 23 December 2012, after a lengthy, self-imposed informational blackout, my high-level DHS contact known as Rosebud emerged with new, non-public information about plans being discussed and prepared for implementation by the Department of Homeland Security, DHS, in the near future. It is important to note that this blackout was directly related to the aggressive federal initiative of identifying and prosecuting leakers. At least those leaks and leakers not sanctioned by the executive office, the latter of which there are many. Due to those circumstances, my source exercised an abundance of caution to avoid compromising a valuable line of communication until he had information he felt was significant enough to risk external contact. The following information is the result of an in-person contact between this author and Rosebud within the last 48 hours. With his permission, the interview was digitally recorded and the relevant portions of the contact are provided in a conversational format for easier reading. The original recording was copied onto multiple disks and are maintained in secure locations for historical and insurance purposes. Meeting. The following began after an exchange of pleasantries and other unrelated discussion. DH, do I have your permission to record this conversation? RB, you do. DH, I've received a lot of email from people wondering where you went and why you've been so quiet. RB, as I told you earlier, things are very dicey. Weird things began to happen before the election and have continued since. Odd things, a clampdown of sorts. I started looking and I found, redacted AT, the request of this source, and that shook me up. I'm not the only one, though, that found a redacted, so this means there's surveillance of people within DHS by DHS. So, that explains this cloak and dagger stuff for this meeting. DH, I understand. What about the others? RB, they are handling it the same way. DH, I've received many emails asking if you are the same person giving information to Ulsterman. Are you? RB, no, but I think I know at least one of his insiders. DH, care to elaborate? RB, sorry, no. DH, do you trust him or her? I mean, the Ulsterman source? RB, yes. DH, Okay, so last August, you said things were going hot. I printed what you said, and things did not seem to happen as you said. RB, you'd better recheck your notes and compare them with some of the events leading up to the election. I think you'll find that a full-blown campaign of deception took place to make certain Obama got back into office. The polls, the media, and a few incidents that happened in the 2 months before the election. I guess if people are looking for some big event they can point to and say, aha, for verification, well then I overestimated people's ability to tell when they are being lied to. DH, what specific incidents are you referring to? RB, look at the threats to Obama. Start there. The accusations of racism. Then look at the polls, and especially the judicial decisions about voter ID laws. Bought and paid for, or where there was any potential for problems, the judges got the message, loud and clear. Then look at the voter fraud. And not a peep from the Republicans. Nothing. His second term was a done deal in September. This was planned. Frankly, the Obama team knew they had its own up long before Election Day. Benghazi could have derailed them, but the fix was in there, so I never saw anything on my end to suggest a ready-made solution had to be implemented. DH, what's going on now? RB, people better pay close attention over the next few months. First, there won't be any meaningful deal about the fiscal crisis. This is planned. I mean, the lack of deal is planned. In fact, it's necessary to pave the way for what is in the short-term agenda. DH, wait, you're DHS, not some Wall Street insider. RB, so you think they are separate agendas? That's funny. The coming collapse of the United States dollar is a done deal. It's been in the works for years, decades, and this is one of the most important cataclysmic events that DHS is preparing for. I almost think that DHS was created for that purpose alone, to fight Americans, not protect them, right here in America. But that's not the only reason. There's the gun issue too. DH, so, what are you seeing at DHS? RB, we don't have a lot of time. Tonight, our meeting, as well as a country. I mean, I have heard, with my own ears, plans being made that originate from the White House that involve the hierarchy of DHS. You gotta know how DHS works at the highest of levels. It's Jared and Napolitano, with Jared organizing all of the plans and approaches. She's the one in charge, at least from my point of view, from what I am seeing. Obama knows that's going on and had say, but it seems that Jared has the final say, not the other way around. It's screwed up. This really went into high gear since the election. But it's a train wreck at mid-management, but is more effective at the lower levels. A lot of police departments are being gifted with federal funds with strings attached. That money is flowing out to municipal police departments faster than it can be counted. They are using this money to buy tanks. Well, not real tanks, but you know what I mean. DHS is turning the police into soldiers. By the way, there has been a lot of communication recently between Napolitano and Pistole, the head. They are planning to use the agents in tandem with local police for certain operations that are being planned right now. This is so deleted, important that you cannot even begin to imagine. If you get nothing else out of this, please, please make sure you tell people to watch Towsey and their increasing involvement against the American public. They are the stooges who will be the ones to carry out certain plans when the dollar collapses and the gun confiscation begins. DH, whoa, wait a minute. You just said a mouthful. What's the agenda here? RB, your intelligence insider, he knows that we are facing a planned economic collapse. You wrote about this in your articles about Benghazi, or at least that's what I got out of the later articles. So why the surprise? DH, there's a lot here. Let's take it step by step if you don't mind. RB, okay, but I'm not going to give it to you in baby steps. Big boy steps. This is what I am hearing. Life for the average American is going to change significantly, and not the change people expect. First, DHS is preparing to work with police departments and etc. to respond to civil uprisings that will happen when there is a financial panic. And there will be one, maybe as early as this spring, when the dollar won't get you a gumball. I'm not sure what the catalyst will be, but I've heard rumblings about a derivatives crisis as well as an oil embargo. I don't know, that's not my department. But something is going to happen to collapse the dollar, which has been in the works since the 1990s. Now if it does not happen as soon as this, it's because there are people, real patriots, who are working to prevent this, so it's a fluid dynamic. But that doesn't change the preparations. And the preparations are these: DHS is prepositioning assets in strategic areas near urban centers all across the country. Storage depots, armories, and even detainment facilities, known as FEMA camps. FEMA does not even know that the facilities are earmarked for detainment by executive orders, at least not in the traditional sense they were intended. By the way, people drive by some of these armories every day without even giving them a second look. Commercial and business real estate across the country are being bought up or leased for storage purposes. Very low profile. Anyway, I am hearing that the plan from on high is to let the chaos play out for a while, making ordinary citizens beg for groups to be deployed to restore order. But it's all organized to make them appear as good guys. That's when the real head knocking will take place. We're talking travel restrictions, which should not be a problem because gas will be rationed or unavailable. DHS will be in charge of travel, or at least be a big part of it. They will be commissioned, upgraded from their current status. They, I mean Jared and Obama as well as a few others in government, are working to create a perfect storm too. This is being timed to coincide with new gun laws. DH, new federal gun laws. RB, yes. Count on the criminalization to possess just about every gun you can think of. Not only restrictions, but actual criminalization of possessing a banned firearm. I heard this directly from the highest of my sources. Plans were made in the 90s but were withheld. Now, it's a new day, a new time, and they are riding the wave of emotion from Sandy Hook. Which, by the way, and as tragic as it was, well, it stinks to high heaven. I mean, there are many things wrong there, and first reports are fast disappearing. The narrative is being changed. Look, there is something wrong with Sandy Hook, but if you write it, you'll be called a kook or worse. DH, sure, RB, but Sandy Hook, there's something very wrong there. But I am hearing that won't be the final straw. There will be another if they think it's necessary. DH, another shooting. RB, yes. DH, that would mean they're at least complicit. RB, well, that's one way of looking at it. DH, are they? Were they? RB, dear own research. Nothing I say, short of bringing you photographs and documents, will convince anyone, and even then, it's like, deluted, in the wind. DH, so. RB, so what I'm telling you is that DHS, that's and certain, but not all, law enforcement agencies are going to be elbow deep in riot control in response to an economic incident. At the same time or close to it, gun confiscation will start. It will start on a voluntary basis using federal registration forms, then on amnesty, then the kicking in of doors start. Before or at the same time, you know all the talk of lists, you know, the red and blue lists that everyone made fun of. Well, they exist, although I don't know about their colors. But there are lists of political dissidents maintained by DHS. names are coordinated with the executive branch, but you know what? They did not start with Obama. They've been around in one form or another for years. The difference, though, is that today, they are much more organized. And I'll tell you that the vocal opponents of the politics of the global elite, the bankers, and the opponents of anything standing in their way, well, they are on the top of the list of people to be handled. DH, handled. RB, as the situations worsen, some might be given a chance to stop their vocal opposition. Some will, others won't. I suppose they are on different lists. Others won't have that chance. By that time, though, it will be chaos and people will be in full defensive mode. They will be hungry, real hunger like we've never experienced before. They will use our hunger as leverage. They will use medical care as leverage. DH, will this happen all at once? RB, they hope to make it happen at the same time. Big cities first, with sections being set apart from the rest of the country. Then the rural areas. There are two different plans for geographical considerations. But it will all come together. DH, wait, this sounds way, way over the top. Are you telling me? Interrupts, RB. Overtalk / unintelligible. Know who was selected or elected twice now. You know who his associates are. And you are saying this is way over the top? Don't forget what Ayers said, you talkulary graph, whoa. This guy is a revolutionary. He does not want to transform our country in the traditional sense. He will destroy it. And he's not working alone. He's not working for himself, either. He has his handlers. So don't think this is going to be a walk in the park with some type of attempt to rescue the country. Cloward Piven. Alinsky. Marx. All rolled into one. And he won't need the rest of his 4 years to do it. DH, I need you to be clear. Let's go back again, I mean, to those who speak out about what's happening. RB. Edit note, obviously irritated, how much clearer do you want it? The Second Amendment will be gone, along with the First, at least practically or operationally. The Constitution will be gone, suspended, at least in an operational sense. Maybe they won't actually say that they are suspending it, but will do it. Like saying the sky is purple when it's actually blue. How many people will look at the sky and say, yeah, it's purple? They see what they want to see. So the DHS, working with other law enforcement organizations, especially the UP as it stands right now, will oversee the confiscation of assault weapons, which includes all semi-automatic weapons following a period of so-called amnesty. It also includes shotguns that hold multiple rounds, or have pistol grips. They will go after the high-capacity magazines, anything over, say, 5 rounds. They will also go after the ammunition, especially at the manufacturer's level. They will require a special license for certain weapons, and make it impossible to own anything. More draconian than England. This is a global thing too. Want to hunt? What gives you the right to hunt their animals? Sounds strange? I hope so, but they believe they own the animals. Do you understand now how sick and twisted this is? Their mentality. The obvious intent is to disarm American citizens. They will say that we'll still be able to defend ourselves and go hunting, but even that will be severely regulated. This is the part that they are still working out, though. While the plans were made years ago, there is some argument over the exact details. I know that Napolitano, even with her support of the agenda, would like to see this take place outside of an EO, executive order, in favor of legislative action and even with UN involvement. DH, but UN involvement would still require legislative approval. RB, yes, but you're still thinking normal, in normal terms. Stop thinking about a normal situation. The country is divided, which is exactly where Banner wants us to be. We are as ideologically divided as we were during the Civil War, and that rift is growing every day. Add in a crisis, an economic crisis, or ATM and AT cards will stop working. Where bank accounts will contain nothing but air. They are anticipating a revolution and a civil war rolled into one, emphasis added by this author. Imagine when talk show hosts or bloggers or some other malcontent gets on the air or starts writing about the injustice of it all, and about how Obama is the Antichrist or something. They will outlaw such talk or writing as inciting the situation. They will make it illegal by saying that it is causing people to die. The Republicans will go along with everything as it's, we have a one-party system. Two parties is an illusion. It's also surreal to talk about, but you see where this is headed, right? DH, well, what about the lists? RB, back to that again, okay. Why do you think the NSA has surveillance of all communications? To identify and stop terrorism? Okay, to be fair, that is part of it, but not the main reason. The federal agencies have identified people who present a danger to them in their agendas. I don't know if they are color-coded like you mentioned, red, blue, purple, or peach, mango, or whatever, but they exist. In fact, each agency has their own. You know, why is it so deleted? Hard for people to get their heads around the existence of lists with names of people who pose a threat to their plans? The media made a big deal about Nixon's enemies list and everyone nodded and said yeah, that, deleted, but today, they've been around for years and years. DH, I think it's because of the nature of the lists today. What do they plan to do with their enemies? RB, go back to what Iris said when, in the late 60s, 70s? I forget. Anyway, he was serious. But to some extent, the same thing that happened before. They, the people on some of these lists, are under surveillance, or at least some, and when necessary, some are approached and made an offer. Others, well, they can be made to undergo certain training. Let's call it sensitivity training, except on a much different level. Others, most that are the most visible and mainstream, are safe for the most part. And do you want to know why? It's because they are in the pockets of the very people we are talking about, but they might or might not know it. Corporate sponsorship, follow the money. You know the drill. You saw it happen before, with the birth certificate. It's people that are just under the national radar but are effective. They have to worry. Those who have been publicly marginalized already but continue to talk or write or post, they are in trouble. It's people who won't sell out, who think that they can make a difference. Those are the people who have to worry. Think about recent deaths that everybody believes were natural or suicides. Were they? People are too busy working there, butts off to put food on the table to give a damn about some guy somewhere who vapor locks because of too many donuts and coffee and late nights. And it seems plausible enough to happen. This time, when everything collapses, do you think they will care if it is a bullet or a heart attack that takes out the opposition? Deleted, no. DH, that's disturbing. Do you? Interrupts. RB. Think about the Oklahoma City bombing in single quote 95. Remember how Clinton blamed that on talk radio, or at least in part. Take what happened then and put it in context of today. Then multiply the damnation by 100, and you will begin to understand where this is going. People like Rush and Hannity have a narrow focus of political theater. They'll still be up and running during all of this to allow for the appearance of normal. Stay within the script, comrade. But as far as the others, they have certain plans. And these plans are becoming more transparent. They are getting bolder. They are pushing lies, and the bigger the lie, the easier it is to sell to the people. They will even try to sell a sense of normalcy as things go absolutely crazy and break down. It will be surreal. And some will believe it, think that it's only happening in certain places, and we can draw everything back once the dust settles. But when it does, this place will not be the same. DH, will there be resistance within the ranks of law enforcement? You know, will some say they won't go along with the plan, like the Oath Keepers? RB, absolutely. But they will not only be outnumbered, but outgunned, literally. The whole objective is to bring in outside forces to deal with the civil unrest that will happen in America. And where does their allegiance lie? Certainly not to Sheriff Bob. Or you or me. During all of this, and you've got to remember that the dollar collapse is a big part of this, our country is going to have to be redone. I've seen, personally, a map of North America without borders. Done this year. The number 2015 was written across the top, and I believe that was meant as a year. Along with this map, in the same area where this was another map showing the United States cut up into sectors. I'm not talking about what people have seen on the internet, but something entirely different. Zones. And a big star on the city of Denver. Sound like conspiracy stuff on the internet. Yup. But maybe they were right. It sure looks that way. It will read that way if you decide to write about this. Good luck with that. Anyway, the country seemed to be split into sectors, but not the kind shown on the internet. Different. DH, what is the context of that? RB, across the bottom of this was written economic sectors. It looked like a work in progress, so I can't tell you any more than that. From the context, I think it has to do with the collapse of the dollar. DH, why would DHS have this? I mean, it seems almost contrived, doesn't it? RB, not really, when you consider the bigger picture. But wait, before we go off into that part. I need to tell you about Obamacare, you know, the new healthcare coming up. It plays a big part, a huge, deleted, part in the immediate reshaping of things. DH, how so? RB, it creates a mechanism of centralized control over people. That's the intent of this monster of a bill, now affordable health care. And it will be used to identify gun owners. Think your health records are private? Have you been to the doctor lately? Asked about owning a gun? Why do you think they ask? Do you think they care about your safety? Say yes to owning a gun and your information is shared with another agency and ultimately, you will be identified as a security risk. The records will be matched with other agencies. You think that they are simply relying on gun registration forms? This is part of data collection that people don't get. Oh, and don't even think about getting a script for some mood enhancement drug and being able to own a gun. Iris and Dorn are having the times of their lives seeing things they've worked for all other adult lives actually coming to pass. Oh, before I forget, look at the recent White House visitor logs. DH, why? Where did that come from? RB, unless they are redacted, you will see the influence of Iris. Right now, the Weather Underground has been reborn. So has their agenda. DH, eugenics. Population control? RB, yup. And re-education camps. But trust me, you write about this, you'll be called a kook. It's up to you, it's your reputation, not mine. And speaking about that, you do know that this crew is using the internet to ruin people, right? They are paying people to infiltrate discussion sites and forums to call people like you idiots. Show me the proof, they say. Why doesn't U.S.A come forward? If he knows so much, why not go to Fox or the media? To them, if it's not broadcast on CNN, it's not real. Well, they've got it backwards. Very little on the news is real. The stock market, the economy, the last presidential polls, very little is real. But this crew is really internet savvy. They've got a lot of people they pay to divert issues on forums, to mock people, to marginalize them. They know what they are doing. People think they'll take sites down, hack them. Why do that when they are more effective to infiltrate the discussion? Think about the birth certificate, I mean the eligibility problem of Obama. Perfect example. DH, how soon do you see things taking place? RB, they already are in motion. If you're looking for a date, I can tell you. Remember, the objectives are the same, but plans, well, they adapt. They exploit. Watch how this fiscal cliff thing plays out. This is the run-up to the next big economic event. I can't give you a date. I can tell you to watch things this spring. Start with the inauguration and go from there. Watch the metals when they dip. It will be a good indication that things are about to happen. Unlike follow post, December 29, 2012 at 8:34 a.m. You want Christian Sanchez like this. Tommy Varol leave Canada and America as soon as possible.
Please share this with everybody. The time is running out. And only those that have an idea what's happening will have a chance to at least be able to understand what's happening. They need to know. You know, watching television and corporate media, it's not the answer. I've been trying to help people now for 30 years and posting stuff on the internet and risking everything, and people won't even lift up their heads to look. Stop being an idiot.